First, land is not a depreciable asset because A. It is held for use in the business. B. It has an infinite life. C. It has a finite life. D. It is not held for resale. Land is not a depreciable asset because it has an infinite life. The answer should be 1B. It is true that land may be held for use in the business, but the C statement, it does not have a finite life, it has an infinite life, and land is not held for resale. While these two factors are true, but it is not considered to be a depreciable asset because it has an infinite life. So the right answer, 1B. Next, obsolescence of a depreciable asset may be caused by technological changes, 2. Improvement in production method, 3. Change in the market demand for the product or service output, 4. Legal or other restrictions. The options are A. Only technological change, B. Technological change as well as improvement in production method, C. All of the four reasons, and D option was legal or other restrictions. Obsolescence may be caused by all of these reasons. It is possible that an asset becomes obsolete due to technology changes, because of some innovation in the production method, because there is a change in the market demand, because of other legal or other restrictions. Therefore, our correct answer should be 2C. Next, the main objective of providing depreciation is A. The options are A. Reduce tax burden, B. Provide funds for replacement of fixed asset, C. Show true financial position in the balance sheet, and D. Comply with legal requirements. When we charge depreciation, it is true that the tax burden does come down. But we are looking at what is the main objective of providing for depreciation. The main objective would be to provide funds for replacement of the asset. The answer should be 3B. Let us just go through the other options, C and D. It shows the true financial position in the balance sheet, which is true. And we need to charge depreciation in order to comply with the legal requirements. But if we have to pick one out of these four reasons, it would be B, provide funds for replacement of an asset. Therefore, the correct answer would be 3B, provide funds for replacement of fixed asset. I repeat, it does help to reduce tax burden and to show the true financial position and to comply with legal requirements are also the objectives of providing depreciation. However, when we are given a choice of four and we need to pick only one, we pick the closest one, the most important one, and therefore the correct answer would be 3B, provide funds for replacement of a fixed asset. 4. Depreciation is the process of A. Asset valuation, B. Verification of assets, C. Allocation of cost of assets to the period of its life, and D. Decreasing the value of asset. Depreciation is the process of, the answer should be C. Allocation of cost of assets to the period of its life. It is true that as a result of depreciation, the value of an asset comes down. However, depreciation, what is depreciation? It is the process of allocation of the cost of assets to the period of its life. Therefore, the correct answer would be 4C. Next, state whether the following statements are true or false. Machines purchased by a machinery dealer for resale is a depreciable asset. Machines purchased by a machinery dealer for resale is a depreciable asset. This should be false. Why is it false? Because machines which are purchased for resale is a current asset, not a non-current asset. Any asset which is meant for resale is not a depreciable asset. Therefore, though machines ordinarily are considered to be a non-current asset, a fixed asset, or machines which are purchased by a machinery dealer for resale, it becomes goods for the particular dealer. It is a current asset for the dealer, and therefore it is not a depreciable asset. Therefore, it is not the asset by itself which determines whether it is a depreciable asset or not, but it is the other features, the purpose for which it is used, that determines whether it is a depreciable asset or not. So, since machines were purchased for resale, therefore it is not a depreciable asset. B. Depreciation may arise on an unused asset based only on the passage of time. Is this sentence true or false? Depreciation may arise on an unused asset based only on the passage of time. It is true, because the very definition of depreciation is, what is depreciation? A measurement of a loss in the value of an asset due to use or passage of time or obsolescence. So it is possible that even when we do not use an asset, the value of the asset comes down after a period of time. If I buy a machinery today for 1 lakh, after 3 years, even if I have not used the machinery at all, I will not be able to get a value of 1 lakh for this machinery. Therefore, depreciation may arise on an unused asset based only on the passage of time. True. C. Rates of depreciation are tabulated in Schedule 6 of the Companies Act. Rates of depreciation are tabulated in Schedule 14. In Schedule 14 of the Companies Act. Therefore, this is false. The answers have been disclosed here again. Machines purchased by machinery dealer for resale is a depreciable asset is false. Depreciation may arise on unused asset based only on the passage of time is true. Rates of depreciation are tabulated in Schedule 6 of the Companies Act is false. Schedule 6 of the Companies Act gives us the format of the financial statements, but Schedule 14 will tell us the rates of depreciation.